why do events like this that celebrate the achievement of women in our industry matter so much?
I think because sometimes being a woman in this industry isn't easy. So when we have success, it's nice to just get together and pat ourselves on the back of it, you know. And it's just lovely to be here with so many women that I admire, you know. It's a great event.
Talking about our favourite group of young women, what is in store for season three of Derry Girls? Because I think there's a sense that both for the country and for these girls, it's going to be a pretty tumultuous time of change.
Yeah. I think they're going to... Well, they're still agents and they still get into a lot of trouble, but they're certainly going to grow up a little bit. And there's definitely a very personal journey that they go on, as well as being part of that, a big political one as well, you know. So yeah, it's an exciting time, I think, for them, as they're just on the cusp of adulthood now. So yeah,
I mean, you call them idiots or a bag of dicks, why do you think people have warmed so much to this particular group of girls?
I think because people can recognize themselves, and we've all been a dick when we were young, maybe. So I think it's that there's a fondness for them because they're so flawed and stupid at times, you know, and people recognise themselves in that, I think.
And obviously all the girls have changed and evolved a little bit. Are they all going to be essentially the same people we've loved, or is anyone going to change a bit more than the others? Because that tends to happen when friends are growing up, you know, one person seems to change suddenly more than everyone else.
Yeah, no, I think what I always said about the show was, because the backdrop was so unpredictable, I wanted that group to be a really solid, secure little group of friends. So I think they'll be friends for life, which is quite a sentimental. I don't think anyone will change enough to sort of outgrow the friendship group, if that makes sense.
And are there new faces, new characters that we're going to be meeting in season three?
Yeah, so there's lots of new guest characters, as always. So, like, kind of every episode, we have a new big guest star come in, and that's really exciting, right? That's been good crack. So, looking forward to shooting all that.
Has the astonishing success of the first two series enabled you to get more of your wish list of guest stars?
Definitely, but it has to be right for the show, you know. So the story leads that. So I never really write for a particular actor if the story's right and you know, and there's the right actor that wants to do it. Yeah, that's perfect.
I guess my final question, obviously we're hoping for many more seasons, but I think fans have also been wondering if we'll ever see these girls embarrassing themselves on the big screen. Is that something that you'd be interested to explore, a feature-length story?
That's definitely something we're talking about and something I'd like to explore again. It's just if the story's right. So it's about me figuring all that out at some point.
We'll let you go and do that now.